but you weren't there. The League of Conservation voters endorsed an opponent of mine, one of the incumbent council members, that voted for this project from day one. The Sierra Club endorsed that candidate and supported the incumbent from day one. I refused to interview with any of those committees out of principle. How could they vote for a council member that sides on a project that will destroy the life and property and the future health and safety of our community, let alone the water, the air, the environmental issues, in a community that if you went into the Whitty Hills area, I mean, you would realize that this is just a disaster waiting to happen. I'm a senior vice president for one of the largest insurance and risk management brokerages in the world. I know the issues of risk. I know the issues of the oil and gas industry. I know the issues of the corruption of these industries, of these corporations within our government. We see it in our local government, we see it in our state government, and we see it in our federal government. And enough is enough. So we beg your assistance to find out the facts. If you had our attorney that represented Open Space Legal Defense, Geraldine Scapic, you would actually hear clearly the arguments that were put forward and clearly why you won the case.
Mr. Donovan,
4 weeks ago.
Are you speaking as a representative of the organization?
Yes,
okay,
I am.
You have two more minutes.
Thank you very much. You would understand why we won the case, because you guys just piggybacked onto our case and took up the charge with the help of the LA County Board of Supervisors and with also another taxpayers association that backed them up as well. We won the case 4 or 5 weeks ago. The only settlement you need to settle is you need your money back. You need your money back, and you need to have everything that was damaged by Matrix Oil on that land to be fixed and put back to the manner that it was when it originally, before the project started. This project was sponsored by Don Carnaby from LA County Board of Supervisors. His son, Matt Carnaby, worked for the lobbying firm that supported Matrix Oil and the city of Whittier. This thing stinks. You need to do your homework. These people are in it up to their neck, and enough is enough. We will run again in the 2040 elections, and hopefully we'll win. But the facts are the facts. The truth is the truth. We run against the newspaper machine, the media machine in our neighborhood. We've had a massive fight here, and we need your help. So please, we're reading in the newspaper now that you guys are about to do a backdoor deal on us and start taking money from Matrix Oil to settle this thing. You've won the case. I don't know what your executive director is going on about, but I think when people come behind me with more specific information about the details of this case, hopefully the light bulb will go off and you guys will back us up. We need your help. This is a big issue. This is going to open a Pandora's box for everybody with regards to Prop A. If it starts in our city, where does it end? Thank you very much.
Thank you. My name is Patricia Yoshihara. I'm a resident of Whittier, and I just want to read a portion of the letter that some of you may or may not have received in email form. I am a supporter of the Whittier Hills Oil Watch, WHOW, and someone committed to conserving wildlife and our open space lands. And I strongly urge you to continue to oppose efforts to allow oil drilling in the Whittier Hills Habitat Preserve. WOW and the Open Space Legal Defense Fund fought for more than 3 years to stop the city of Whittier from drilling on land that was purchased with taxpayer money to be preserved in perpetuity as open space. We're thrilled that the LA County Superior Court Judge James C. Chalfant ruled in favor of SMMC, MRCA, finding that the use of a portion of those lands for oil drilling by the city of Whittier violated the public trust. The public trust in Prop A. The Whittier Hills Habitat Preservation Authority was purchased in part with the $9.3 million from Prop A monies. And we really feel, you know, I have relatives in Cerritos, Long Beach, Pasadena, Hacienda Heights. They all voted for Prop A. They supported Prop A back in 92. And because I do support open space land, and because I believe in preserving open space land in perpetuity with the primary purpose to protect the biological diversity of the Fuente Hills, I urge you to continue to help us. Continue to oppose the oil drilling on the Fuente Hills Habitat Preservation Authority. The Whittier main project still resides roughly 1,000 feet above a special needs elementary school. in the base of the preserve, okay? I have children and grandchildren, and I hope to have their future children have at least a legacy of open space. So we do want to, again, hope that you help to support, have principles that you can be proud of. Do not settle for the money. And again, to ditto everything that Nick said, you know, we do thank you for your hopefully continued support.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is Marta Borbon. I'm an educator in Hacienda Heights, and I'm a Whittier resident. I'm also a board member for a while. This location has to be one of the most beautiful places in Southern California, and it's quite far for us Whittierites, but we're here because a number of us would not miss this for the world. This really matters to us. We are representing thousands of people that stand against this oil issue. I personally have had petitions signed against this oil project for Whittier Hills, and let me assure you that it's been very easy getting people to sign those petitions against the oil project. It was like in a matter of weeks, we got about 5,000, over 5,000 petitions signed against this project. It is a rare find. It was rare to find somebody that was really for this project, except for the city council and a few friends of theirs. I can attest that this project is rejected by citizens of Whittier and all the vicinity. During various EIR meetings that were held, we had dozens and dozens and dozens of professionals all speaking and all agreeing on against the issue. Geologists talking about faults, possible pipes breaking, possible fires, especially on those very dry hills. We had doctors and nurses talking about health hazards and chemicals. We had engineers on issues related to light pollution, noise pollution, traffic issues. We had teachers speaking on the proximity to the special ed school. We had environmentalists speaking on air pollution, real estate agents talking about lowering property values, and the Whittier City Council refused to listen to the long lines of people that were against this. I find it a crime to sacrifice those hills and the well-being of the community for a sum of money. I wonder, is there a price for derailing your environmental purposes? Will you stand up by your commitment to preserve nature? Please think of future generations. And he said there was no factual, I don't know, it is a fact. Judge Chalfant found it ridiculous and ordered the oil company to stop what they were doing. That is a fact. It's ridiculous. We are here today still discussing raping that beautiful piece of land purchased with Proposition A funds with the intention of designated for it, which was recreation and environmental protection of open space in Los Angeles. And so I'm going to read you this thing that you've heard a million times. You probably, each one, have a t-shirt with this on it. When the last tree is cut down, the last fish eaten, and the last stream poisoned, will you realize that you cannot eat money? And I do not get tired of standing up for the Whittier Hills and for their protection, and I just beg you to stand up with us. We represent the majority, the overwhelming majority of Whittier. Thank you.
When he and Matt Birkenhammer, I hope I didn't pronounce that.
Thank you for allowing me to speak. My name is Terry Wilkinson. I'm a resident of Whittier, and I'm a member of the WOW group. First of all, I have to say how impressed I am with, I don't know her name, she mentioned you have saved 69,000 acres over the course of this. That's very impressive. We're just asking you to save a few more. First of all, I want to make sure that you all understand that this proposed oil drilling area is not just one of those little grasshopper things. It's the size of 7 football fields. Okay? It's huge. It also has a processing plant there. Now, I'm here to fight for my neighborhood, for my home and my fellow Whittier residents' homes. Regarding the settlement coming up, I urge you to settle for nothing less than attorney court costs and enough money to make the site pristine again, the way it was before the Matrix Oil Company raped it. Do not, I repeat, do not come to any agreement that would allow Matrix to drill anywhere on the site. No matter how much money Matrix Oil offers everyone involved, the whole point of the lawsuit was that the land be kept open for perpetuity as the taxpayers voted in 1992, and I'm sorry, but they didn't read 16B. Okay, even the judge said that the intent, the spirit of Prop A was nothing be built up there. He said, I'm not picking on you, Big Oil. He said, you can't build a mall up there, and you can't even build a popcorn stand up there. I went to the court, and I listened to him, and he was right. And you know he was right, too. I'm a taxpayer who voted for the open space, and we are the ones who have to actually live there. Okay? WOW gave up our lawsuit date to MRCA and the county so you could help us fight Big Oil and stop any chance of drilling, and the judge agreed. If MRCA changes horses in midstream now and allows Matrix to drill just because they were offered lots of money, I would feel, personally, that we have been stabbed in the back. Do not let greed knock out common sense. Once that genie is out of the bottle, it will never go back in. And those of us who live in the area will have to deal with the poisonous chemicals, cancer-causing chemicals, dirt, traffic, noise, and devalued properties as a result. Be happy with the fact that you won the lawsuit, an amazing feat unto itself. Let's just finish this up with a minimum of fuss and put it in the history books as a win for the little guys against Big Oil. Yeah.
My name is Roy McKee, and I am the president of WOW. First question I want to ask everybody in this room.
Louder, use the microphone. Okay.
Who has been into the Whittier Hills of everybody in this room on this board? Have you seen the property in question? It's beautiful up there, isn't it? It's one, of my understanding, one of two corridors that exist in the entire state of California. It runs from the 605 freeway down to the Cleveland National Forest. It's unique. Nobody else has it. We have deer that run in our yards and all kinds of wildlife. And right now, this oil project has been put right in the middle of the nursery for the bobcats. But let me tell you how this got started. It was actually the Pointy Hills Habitat Authority who helped push this through as a revenue source. If you don't believe me, I suggest you go on our website. You can see the judge's ruling. Please read that before you make any decision. Your executive director was way off base. Way off base. This wasn't even close. This was not a fuzzy line. It was black and white on the wind. And there was a lot of issues in there. Breach of contract, all kinds of stuff that went on. Anyway, this oil project started in 2006 with the city of Whittier, October 18th to be exact. We have the emails. I've been through tens of thousands of documents and emails. So it started with Whittier trying to make a deal, and it was the oil company that came in to try to do this outside of our landfill. Somewhere in this process, the Habitat Authority got involved, and they were strong players. And they received, whether you know it or not, they've been receiving money from this project since 2008. It bought them a biologist. It's in the report, in the lease. You can see that. Bob Henderson's group, and I'm sure some of you probably know him, they're running out of funding this year. Well, we put all the pieces to the puzzle together. What happened? This project, they signed in 2008. They couldn't sign it any later because the oil company said it would take